significant disadvantage to come after Mr. Gupta and Mr. Vasant on a panel of this nature, simply because with their expertise, I think many of the key issues have already surfaced, and you know, there's hardly, all I have to do is really say what Mr. Gupta said and how it applies to our organization. Let me just start, having said that, let me try to say a few things that will hopefully put in context the way we see this. And let me start by saying that, you know, e-commerce is a very, if you look at the share of attention that e-commerce gets in Walmart relative to the share of our revenue that comes from e-commerce, it's a low single digits percentage globally that we make out of e-com. But if you look at every session, every discussion, every leadership meeting, the focus on e-commerce, on omni-channel, on multi-channel is overwhelming. It has been one of our key strategic initiatives for the last several years. And the reason is pretty obvious, I think, is some of the points that the gentleman have mentioned, which is that this is really a customer-led requirement. You know, the customers want to interact with us where they want to interact with us and not where we would like to interact with them, making it absolutely incumbent on us to reach them where they are, how they want to be reached, and I think mobile is a very big part of that, Nitin, so thank you for bringing that up. And the web, of course, which is getting more and more, you know, widely accessible to customers. So I think the challenge, if you will, for a retailer of our nature is to deliver the same value that we deliver in our stores with much greater convenience and with hopefully the same amount of simplicity to a significantly larger group of customers that are more spread out, you know, anywhere and anytime. So both in terms of place and in time. So I think the point I want to emphasize there is that this is customer-led. This is not something that, to the point Nitin made, that retailers have a choice about being online or not being online. You have to be where your customers are. I think one of the things that, you know, as you look at these staggering numbers that is easy to forget, and something that Mr. Gupta brought up very well, is the challenges of fulfillment in the physical world. When you look at, you know, so you have all of this great demand out there, all of these customers that are looking for product that want to buy, and then the question that remains is, what do you do with your existing operations and with your existing capabilities or your future capabilities to be able to actually effectively address the challenge of getting that product to those customers with roughly a similar promise to the convenience that they enjoy today in your brick and mortar stores? And I think that is really where I feel that an organization of our size or our scale has something to bring, which is our ability to fulfill. So the considerable experience in logistics and supply chain, in merchandising, that actually enables you to take what you do in the store and deliver it, or as close as you can get to that, to the online or on mobile, you know, group of customers. That is really, I think, the key proposition, and that is really the place. So customer experience, fulfilling the promise that you make to customers online, those are, I think, two of the big things that we care very deeply about in the Walmart world. The other thing, I think, and Nitin brought this fantastic point up about pricing, I think there were some very good discussions on where you go. I think with us, the advantage has been that our proposition on value has been so strong that the challenge is really not to do anything different, but to keep it consistent, you know, online. And that brings me to a point that I was discussing with Mr. Vasant before the session, which is, how do you portray yourself online consistently with your personality as an organization and convey the same promise? Because to Nitin's point, technology has come to a point where you can be anything to anybody if that is what you really want to be. But I think the challenge with our scale and with our presence is, how do you be online what you are offline? You know, how do you make sure that you are consistent, you're not doing anything online that takes away, that in fact that should positively contribute to build and maintain your reputation and your brand as who you are? And I think that is a very big consideration when you already have a very established brand when you are very well known in the market, when people understand what you bring. The other piece I wanted to touch upon briefly really is, you know, the SEGA, SEGBI customers that Nitin was talking about. And if you look at some of our propositions, they are actually across the spectrum. The marginal customer is also, you know, a big Walmart shopper in the US. And, you know, in many cases, the difference, of course, is that it's not, shall I say, the basket that matters as much as the frequency and the fact that, you know, if you have a particular sum of money in your pocket, where can you maximize that money in terms of getting value out of it? And I think that's also a very big play. Of course, you may not have the ability to do the same level of personalization or the same level of deep service that several of the more specialized organizations might have. But I think it's a very big segment to be addressed, is what can you do with technology to drive convenience all the way down to the marginal consumer? Because our assumption that, you know, if you will, that only people that are above a particular, you know, segment will be able to use or engage with smartphones or with technology. I think that assumption is relatively quickly changing, you know, with the decrease in cost of smartphones and so on. And at least my experience would indicate that before long, we will see people engaging with technology at a point where the income doesn't seem to be quite as relevant. Of course, the purchasing power still, you know, is a question. But certainly, the addressing the marginal customer, I think, is going to be a big concern going forward, because the numbers are there, the demand is there. The question is, I think, to the point that Mr. Vasant made, how do you do this profitably? How do you make money doing that? You know, with all the challenges of fulfillment and with your ability to really integrate all of these, add to your scale rather than create inefficiencies in your system. And those are really the kind of challenges, I think, that we've been working on for now several years. And I think the progress is really that over a period of time, the proposition has come where Walmart.com means the same thing as Walmart physically, and it comes to represent the same thing. And I think that is, you know, no inconsiderable achievement. A point I think I'd like to make is that in the end, we're all still learning. I think we learn continuously in this space. I think Nitin will testify that the rate of change of technology and what you can do today versus what you could do, you know, a few months back or a few years back is radically different. The penetration is increasing radically. So I would hate for us to profess some level of, you know, proficiency in this, because the ground keeps changing under you quicker than you can, you know, actually adapt to it. But the hope is that if you're able to align your value proposition with what you are offering online and you're true to yourself, that then you're only building more convenience or more simplicity or more value over a period of time, and that is how you're going to expect to win in this place. So I think to conclude, let me come back to that is probably why e-commerce is such a big and important consideration for every retailer, because, you know, there is the opportunity, there is the threat, but there is absolutely no option of staying away from this thing and riding it out, because this is certainly where the business is going. So thank you very much.